we have in 1 Samuel says, then Saul disguised himself by putting on other clothes and went, and he and two men with them, and they came to the woman by night, and he said what? Conjure up for me, please, and bring up for me whom I shall name to you. In Leviticus, we find it in 19, it says, regard not them that have what?
Spirit.
Neither seek after wizards to be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God. And so I just want us to kind of get to understand, if you can't write your questions down, because I have a lot, so I want to keep working, is that, man, the Bible talks about this a lot, and these things we have to be so careful of because it's all around us, and the whole thing is that sometimes we don't know. Here's one that's actually recent. I'm trying to show you how it's from the past and it's to the present. It's always been here, and that's what Satan does. He takes a lot of different things to manipulate us and to indoctrinate us. So watch this one.
Talking about a man.
Okay. It might lead to something else. I mean, let's keep kind of getting some more information, because now listen to what she's talking about here.
Sometimes I think
it's an interview.
When they meet me and they speak with me, they think Dasha. And I'm really kind of shy, and not really shy, but more reserved, and nothing like Dasha. But I guess I wouldn't be very entertaining on stage. Dasha comes out and she's good, and she can do things that I cannot do when I'm in rehearsal. I mean, I can try, but then it just doesn't happen. I can sing notes and sing strong and do all these things that when I'm just by myself, I can't do. And I remember right before I performed, I raised my hand up, and it was kind of the first time I felt something else come into me. And I knew that was going to be my coming out night for the BT.
How was she speaking on Sasha Fierce? For those that don't know, she has now changed, so she's called Sasha Fierce now. And so how was she speaking of Sasha Fierce? Was it just a stage name?
No.
Like it's a spirit. It's a different person. It's a different spirit.
Yeah.
Well, she said spirit.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. It's best when you get things from them. It's so important that we're understanding the attack that we're under. And again, sometimes they don't know any better. The worst is, remember, they talk about how the deceived are deceived. Yeah. And they're deceiving others, but they themselves are deceived.
And everybody said for years that you sell your soul when you make it big in Hollywood.
Well, that's a whole other day. But the main thing I'm trying to... Now, what's interesting is the album cover is called what? You have to watch things. Just Sasha Fierce? I am Sasha Fierce. I am. Where did I am? Where's that from? Where do I know that from?
Nowhere.
Because in the Bible it talks about like.
Where did God say I am? He's saying that she's calling herself God by saying I am. This is supposed to be a Christian woman, though. So it's not like she don't know the words. It's not like she doesn't know some of these things. And so there's at no point I'm going to say I am. Is it for us to know the word? So, I mean, it's just, maybe not. I'm just saying she should know better.
That's right.
And here she's talking about invoking of spirits.
Where's her pastor?
Beyonce confesses that she calls on the spirit of Sasha Fierce. Listen, let's go back to the hate the lyrics. Remember those walls I built? You know, well, baby, they're tumbling down. They didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make a sound. I found a way to what?
Let you in.
But I never really had a doubt. Standing in the light. Then we were talking about light, illumination, gnosis. Again, all of those things are connected of your halo. I got my angel now. It's like I've been
awakened.
Remember, we talked about awakening. Every rule I had you breaking is the risk that I'm taking. I ain't never going to shut you out. I'm everywhere I'm looking now, I'm surrounded by your embrace. Baby, I can see your halo. You know you're my
saving
grace. So again, I mean, it's just kind of interesting how it all comes together. Look at this one. First, just notice what she's in. There's another in her video. She's dressed in all white and has black as her covers. Now all of a sudden, she's going to start levitating. What does levitation only represent? No, possession. You guys see the dove? The dove isn't descending, the dove is what? What is that? I'm just saying, what is that about? I'm just saying, what is that about? There's so many things that, and the thing is that, man, we'll be sitting here and we'll be like, no, not Beyonce. No, and we'll talk about some of the people that we have lifted up as gods. Man, we cannot lift up people higher than God. We have to see things. Jesus said that you will know them by what? Her fruits are not matching the fruits that Christ said that we should bear. And so people, man, they can take this a lot of different ways if they want. But she herself has been talking about invoking the spirit of Sasha Fierce. Mm-hmm. And the thing is, you see this over and over, you might watch this one. Now, Michael's been known for invoking spirits and mirrors.
Personal involvement in the occult, but later admissions contradicted his denial. Satanist Aleister Crowley had a special secret room filled with mirrors where he practices black magic and contacted demonic beings. Like Aleister Crowley, Michael Jackson also uses a secret room of mirrors to contact spirits. Michael Jackson has admitted that it is in this room that he communes with the spirit of Lee Liberace. Jackson revealed that, quote, I have my own secret room with a moving wall and mirrors. That's where I talk to Lee. His is the voice I hear in there. I feel his presence so very close to me. Jackson added that Liberace is, quote, like my guardian angel. He's even given me permission to record his theme song, I'll Be Seeing You. Obviously, Michael Jackson is not in contact with the spirit of Liberace. For the word of God states that one goes to either heaven or hell on death. But like Satanist Aleister Crowley, Michael Jackson has opened himself up to the demonic spirit world, which is using him, like so many other rock stars, as a tool to damn the souls of men and women. It is from this demonic spirit world that Michael Jackson gets his songs. Jackson admitted, quote, I wake up from dreams and go, wow, put this down on paper. The whole thing is strange. You hear the words. Everything is right there in front of your face. And you say to yourself, I'm sorry, I just didn't write this. It's there already. I feel that somewhere, someplace, it's all been done. And I'm the courier bringing it into the world. It appears that it is these demonic beings that energize Jackson when he hits the stage. Jackson said, quote, when I hit the stage, it's all of a sudden a magic from somewhere that comes and the spirit just hits you. And you lose control of yourself.
Man, again, you keep seeing a pattern in some of these big artists. What was your question?
But that's what I was thinking about Michael Jackson. People worship Michael Jackson as their evil god.
Absolutely. It's not any different. I think you had a question earlier. Okay. Again, I'm just trying to show us how this idea of invoking of spirits. Something that God said is detestable is all around us. Look at some of these things. Look at the things that they shared in common. They both felt empowered by their spirits. A cult, they gained power through these spirits. Satan does have power. His power is not greater than God, but he does have power. He can give people power. That's why he's going to end up giving power to the Antichrist. But we have to understand that this power is demonic. Acts says, it happened that as we were going to the place of prayer, a slave girl having a spirit of divination met us, who was bringing her master much profit by fortune telling. She was making money, and her master was making money off of this whole invoking of spirits and mediums. What else do they have in common? Some believe that they are in control and seeking good spirits. What was, remember the one that we were talking about where they were talking about Wicca and how they're talking about spells? And yeah, you know, we have these spells and we're in control of these things. I would never cast a spell, a love spell. And a video prior to that one, the guy was talking about, yeah, you know, we have these, the circle. So they're supposed to be, the circle is supposed to ward off evil spirits. And then they just keep the good spirits. And so it goes back and forth. But look in Luke 11. When the unclean spirit goes out of a man, it passes through waterless places, seeking rest and not finding any. It says, I will return to my house from which I came. And when it comes and it finds it swept and put in order, then it goes and takes along seven other spirits. More what?
More evil
than itself. And they go in and live there, and the last state of that man becomes worse than the first. Man, we don't need to be playing around with spirits, but with movies and so many different things around us, just with the culture, we see it all around us. We have to be aware. They both use mirrors in their spiritual experience. Well, where were the mirrors? First, how many remember Bloody Mary? Mirrors have actually been a practice of witchcraft and magic and sorcery for a long, long time. And so what I thought was always a joke, you know, that wasn't a joke. I mean, that they use mirrors in their spells and different things that they're doing. And so that's where Aleister Crowley, he would have a room full of mirrors when he was evoking on his spirit. Michael Jackson had rooms full of mirrors. He was famous for those. And then now we find, it's interesting that in this video, notice all the mirrors. And how you have the light. And so she's dancing a lot in this video in front of these mirrors. So it's just, again, we have to be, it's so important that we're sober, that we're alert, that we're not being misled. Because that's the goal of the enemy. How can I deceive you? How can I make a way into your home and give you something that God said, I don't want you to have this? And we have to be so careful of the things that we take into our home.